Thank you. Step aside for Earthquake Mogul.
First, I stoop to the waist and wrestles the four biggest gifts. Male or female?
Morning, ladies.
Morning, Mary Sam.
And go on, my good man.
Next, I tell us four off-color jokes, guaranteed to embarrass the man the beast. Then, as the applause dies down, I dance a jig with a pig, ties my arms and legs four infuriated mules. And as they run off in all directions, trying to tear me apart, I recite five of the more dynamic speeches of Al Flanagan. Backwards.
Well, that sounds all right, for the lower classes. But the lady I have in mind is entitled to something a little more
forlorn.
Morning, ladies. My Daisy May, you're looking especially pretty today.
Thank you, Mr. McCoon.
It's just what does a red farmer like you want information about a $2 wedding?
Could be so I was able to get married, since I was just returned home with my newly acquired title, namely, world's deadliest wrestler. And being so well-heeled, naturally, I aim to catch me a certain dog catch gal.
You crazy or something?
You know a man can't claim a gal unless she catches him or self on Sadie Hopkins' day.
Well, if you're wanting the answers, I suggest you perambulate over to the fog-bound meet about to be held at Cornpone Square.
Cornpone Square? You mean this is gonna be a cornpone meeting?
By direct request of my good friend, Senator Jackass Fogbound.
This is serious.
We only have cornpone meetings for events of national importance.
Oh, a hideous change in a dog catch way of life.
Oh, there's gonna be a hideous change, all right. Come on, Sam. Now tell me about your $4 wedding.
Well, I don't crave your business, but I can't discriminate. First, I clip your toenails, gives you a quick shave and a sponge bath if you need it, and frankly, I'd say you need it. Then, I make my attractive proposal to the bride's mother.
Looks bad, David. You better hightail down the Polecat Creek and tell Adam and no good skunk to get up that meat.
Right, but what if they druther not?
Just tell them I druther they druther. And when Pansy Yoakum says she druther they druther.
Brother, they druther.
Don't think so. Ain't worth the price.
What price?
Giving up your druthers.
Which druthers?
All of them. You druther go hunting, she druther stay home. You druther do this, she druther do that. I tell you, the day you kiss your bride hello, you kiss your druthers goodbye.
I don't know if your druthers are so
important. Important? If I have my druthers, I druther have my druthers, anything else I know. Accumulating muscle, I'd rather watch daisies grow. While they're growing slow in, the summer breeze is blowing, my heart is overflowing in soul. If I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than anything else.
Figuring a flower is tall. If I had my druthers, I'd druther have my druthers to do any work at all. ain't nothing special about it. It's just so handy, that's all.
If I had my druthers to choose from all the others, I'd druther be like I am. This thing called employment that tracks for my enjoyment, it tightens my diaphragm. While I'm doing every I think it's necessary, I'm happy as a cherry stone clam. If I had my druthers to choose from all the others, I'd druther be like
But I'd rather stay here.
So we might do some talking about some things that might need some talking about.
Well, maybe we ought to do some talking. I ain't going to no meeting. Thanks, you went along.
But Abner, Sadie Hawkins is next Friday, and we's ever going to do some talking about some things.
I told you, I ain't a going.
But Abner.
I ain't a going. I have spoken.
Fine. I just tell Mammy, you ain't a coming to the corn pone meeting.
Corn pone meeting?
Of course.
You didn't say it was a corn pone meeting.
You didn't let me.
Hear that, boys, a corn pone meeting. This must be a national emergency. We better get down there. This might cause some brains or something. Daisy, that's in my words.
If I had my druthers, I'd rather have some brothers to fashion his pumpkin head.
Jubilation, be born, a man who fear, a heart. for months.
Who's that?
Behind that bag, but vigilated at once.
Why, it was Chimblishy Cornpone.
Unshaven and shorn-bone.
Chimblishy Cornpone.
Mark nobody's dumps.
Why, it was Chimblishy Cornpone. Chimblishy Cornpone.
Beautiful green boat, crap, you can take.
Oh, no.
He can't tell no more whether he got snake eyes or box cars.
Oh, no!
That kid fell and turned so brown. You can't tell no more whether your money's playing the field or coming the hard way.
Oh, no!
Those are going on them slot machines.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes, they is. You can't tell no more whether you got two chairs or three plums, three bells or two oranges. And when he hits the jackpot, you don't dare touch your money because it might be radioactive.
That whole industry.
But does he think your government up there in Washington is going to stand by and let a tragedy like this happen to an American industry whom so many have given so much for so little?
No!
No, my good friends, that's why the jackass walk-off has been chosen.
To find a new place to test them bombs?
That's right. Some place they never run into. Some place we can walk the face of the country. In fact, the most unnecessary place in the whole USA.
Well, I'll be dogged.
Now has the honor and privilege of announcing, after a 4-year governmental survey of all the no-good, no-account, unnecessary places in the whole USA, you have been selected as the most unnecessary of all. I proudly be elected by the United States Senate. He is a fine governmental scientist who is going to supervise your evacuation. Citizens, we got the Rasmussen T. Finsdale.
We intend to move you from Dogpatch to a more necessary place in our society. The first detention will be on Wednesday. However, the evacuation will be repeated immediately. Good luck, and thank you.
And so, dear constituents, as I bid you farewell, I beg you don't let me down. Just remember your government is spending $1 million on one bomb to blow your homes off the face of this earth. So show your appreciation.
Easy, pissy close. I want to add to this glorified occasion.
station by making a history-creating romantic announcement. I hereby claim is my bride and Mary, none other than the ever popular Miss Daisy May.
Oh, how dare you? Edna, give him what for?
I bust his head off.
Wait a minute. I just the head busting for the family. Magoon, are you crazy? You know you can't clean the gal. Listen, she catches you on Sadie Hawkins Day.
You heard the man. Daisy's dropping the bomb on Wednesday. And Sadie Hawkins Day ain't till Friday. That means there can't be no Sadie Hawkins Day.
Sadie Hawkins Day, you automatically go back to the court of the hill.
Whereby, if a male desires marriage with a female of the opposite sex, he can claim her as her bride if and he gets permission from her closest kin. Right, little doggy? Right. Therefore, I claim the aforementioned ever popular Miss Daisy May.
Now, is there any other claimants? If there's no other claimants, we're gonna have.
Wait. I also claim to have a popular lady in question.
Doug, what?
I claim Daisy May.
For purposes of marriage.
Well, whatever he's claiming to fall, I'm claiming to fall. Show I means it.
Now, since we have two claimants, decisions to be made by Daisy May's next of kin.
Fair decisions. She already been promised to me by my good friend and her closest relative, the ever sensible Romeo Scram.
Romeo Scram? He's an old good bomb and I'm dead.
I object to.
Shut up. I just object to for his family.
I'm just as objectionable as you are.
You both are objectionable. Now, this way, Romeo Scram's your kin for claim.
Yes, but it's the side of the family that.
What's a Scram? Yeah.
Romeo Scram, did you give Daisy May the earthquake to whom?
Correct.
How can you make such a miserable decision?
Because earthquake's a fine man, a good man, a man who put love in his heart, put faith in his country, and most importantly, just put $4 in my side pocket. Bless you, my children.
Just a minute, I got something to say. Is there a bumper name here?
Yes, what is it?
You was bombing this place because you can't find anything necessary about it, right?
Correct.
Suppose we did find something necessary. What then?
Well, we certainly would bomb any community which made necessary contributions to society.
Okay, then let's all spread out and find something necessary about us.
Yeah, we gotta save out Sadie Hawkins Day.
We gotta protect our rights to womanhood.
Oh, you heard your fellow citizens. They wants to get up and get on out here.
Yeah,
we wanna get out of here. These fine young maids have a right to get out of this miserable pest hole and see the outside world.
Yeah, we want to see the world.
We want to get civilized.
Modernized.
Mary, we want to broaden our horizons.
Oh, you want to broaden your horizons, does you? Well, let me tell you something. Your horizons are broad enough. Particularly yours. You had any idea about the horrible customs they had waiting out there for you?
Like what?
Like a before marriage thing called an engagement.
Engagement? What's that?
It's the time that elapses between when the girl says, "You so do," and the preacher says, "Go to."
Well, how long did you think this thing last?
Sometimes a whole month.
A whole month? That's not healthy. It could ruin your skin.
Yes, my friends. They have all sorts of terrible customs waiting out there for you. You're going to have to take baths.
Oh!
Comb your hair.
Oh, no!
Clean your nails.
Oh, no!
And most of all, you're going to have to go to work.
Let's go.
days, but we gotta help find something necessary.
But Edna, don't you realize what you just done? You finally asked me to marry you.
Yeah, I know. We gotta find
something. Edna, why did you do it?
Oh, I don't know. I just done it, that's all.
But why?
Well, there you were, your sweet usual self. And there was old Goon looking at you like a hound dog on the first day of hunting season. And I ain't gonna let no one look at you like a hound dog, especially not a hound dog like a Goon.
Does this mean you ain't gonna let me catch up if we have Sadie Hawkins there?
I reckon so.
Oh, Abner, what took you so long?
I don't know, Daisy. Some years I wanted to offer bad, but I couldn't. I don't know why I couldn't, but I couldn't.
But there must have been some reason.
So what was it? Take last year's race. There I was loping along my youthful burst of running speed. When I turned around seeing you sweet and pretty reaching out your hand and grabbing for life. When a voice inside of me hollered, Abner, boy, take off! I could.
But that's all behind us now.
You really reckon?
And life's gonna be full of so many wonderful things. Things you've been deserving for such a long, long time.
Maybe what?
Next.
round trip ticket to the birthplace of Elvis Presley.
All right, next.
An application to the Clairvaux Fan Club.
Move along. Next. There's no printing on it. The pages are all blank.
We ain't had no money yet. Somebody sending out print just to keep up the good with.
Interesting, my good man, but hardly a necessity.
It might be. It could be not bad.
Now, this is an order. Pack your things. The trucks will be leaving immediately.
Here comes the bailiff. He'll have something to give anyone.
Well, I got it. I really got it. The most necessary innovation of modern times.
Quickly, what is it?
Here, put these on. Duke of Vine Jones.
What's Duke?
A deadly weapon, guaranteed to stupefy any human male, dead in his trash. I'll send you. Hey, Speedy McGrath, come on over here. Stupefy? Unstupefy.
What you want?
Nothing. Well,
fascinating, but of what utility?
Why she be in belly of college football? Why she can stop hogging on 1 yard line?
Who couldn't? Next.
I got it. I really got it. It's Mammy, our last hole. If you're looking for something necessary to the whole country, I got it right here in this little bottle. My very own special Yokumberry Tonic.
Yokumberry Tonic?
I won't grab the berries with my Yokumberry tree.
Madam? I've never heard of a yokumberry tree.
Well, you wouldn't. There's only one in the whole world.
That's right. And it grows right in their front yard.
Aw, man ain't interested in your phony old yokumberry time.
Phony? My boy ever takes it. And just look at these muscles.
Yeah, look at your muscles.
I'm sorry, madam. We already have more tonics and bodybuilders than we can use.
Excuse me, your body
can use
little
bills. No. Evacuation will begin immediately.
You mean it? There's just nothing about it necessary?
I'm afraid not. I should think that you'd be happy at a chance to get out of a place like this.
But you don't rightly understand, mister. It may not look much to you, but this is our land, our soil. This is where we was raised.
Where our ancestors took their bare hands and made all this out of the wilderness. Our beautiful skunk works.
Where the Oak Shop Railroad.
Beautiful intersection of Hoffman Boulevard and she did try.
Where we was planning to erect our new hotel, Dowagiac Hilton.
Not to mention Cornholton Square.
The folks from Rotten. Who's Green
They call it unnecessary.
They just don't understand, Mammy.
Oh, it's unnecessary, just a speck on the map where the trail from the snow reaches
more than a nickel a
quart,
you
can
buy it
in alcoholic beverage that can be produced and sold to the American public for under 5 cents a quart. Perhaps I better take some.
No need to bother, Doctor. I'll be glad to have a kiss for you.
Very well, if you'd like to.
Water!
I told you!
Water!
Why bother with plain water? Why not try something very deep to build you? Like some yogi peritone.
However, this tonic will lead to exhaustive tests on human guinea pigs. And since you're most affected by the outcome of these tests, I'm asking, are there any volunteers among you?
Hey, wait! You've got one of them right here! If you can make him look anything like Li'l Abner, you got yourself one guinea pig!
Yeah, if that stuff makes something like that out of something like this, you got him.
Discovered a miracle drug which may revolutionize mankind.
Die Welt wurde heute aufgeschreckt bei einer Weißen Hausmeldung, dass ein Dogpatch, ein Junge mit dem Namen Abner Jokum, hat eine neue Wunderdroge entdeckt, die die Menschheit verändern wird.
Mi è stata appena consegnata una recente notizia. Il Presidente degli Stati Uniti ha appena convocato Abner Jokum alla Casa Bianca per una dichiarazione dello stesso Jokum riguardanti sue disposizioni concernenti il problema droga.
Il governo tiene un super segreto acerca del risultato medicinale della droga Abner Young. La stabilidad es efectiva. 6 ciudadanos patriotas de Don Pachac son voluntarios para cuidar conejillos de India. El comprensivo resultado sobre aquellos 6 hombres comenzó hoy, pero el resultado no será conocido por algún tiempo.
The government has claimed top secrecy and extensive medical tests of the Abner Jokum drug. To establish its effectiveness, 6 pediatric citizens from Dowagiac have volunteered as human guinea pigs. Comprehensive tests on these 6 men started today, but the results will not be known for some time.
A light bulb has just been added to me. The President of the United States has just summoned Abner Jokum to the White House for a statement of Jokum's intentions regarding his disposition of the drug.
Secretary?
Yeah, you can read all about me in confidential.
How do you do,
Mr. Yoko?
Chose a pretty bird, ma'am.
Did you shoot it?
No, I kind of trapped it.
Mighty pretty. When does this season open on that stuff?
It never floats.
Joker, my boy. It's time you and I talk a little business. I'm offering you $1 million in cash for the rights to your drug.
But I already told the president.
President? What president?
The president of the United States of America.
Oh, that president. Forget that, my boy. I don't think you comprehend what this little elixir of yours can do.
It stops me bombing my hometown. That's all I cares about.
Idealistic nonsense. Yoko, I have access to top secret government reports, and so far the tests show that this drug of yours exceeds the most fantastic discoveries of science.
Is that good?
Good! Why don't give every male a perfect physique? It makes fat men thin, thin men fat, removes hair from where you don't want it, puts it where it counts the most, it broadens your shoulders, narrows your hips, it builds up your corpuscles, lowers your blood pressure, wakes you up in the morning, puts you to sleep at night, it toughens your skin, it softens your beard, and once more, cleans your breath and leaves your teeth alone.
Show got good manners, don't it?
Help him! Say the word and we'll go into production. We'll bottle it! We'll name it after you. We'll call it
Yoga Cola.
Sauce! We'll make billions! And for starters, here's my check for $1 million.
Thanks, General. But as a 100% red-blooded American, I'd rather give it to the government. So if you'll excuse me, I'd rather catch my bus home. They're running St. Hawkins Day tomorrow, and I can't miss it. Bye, Mr. General. Bye, Ms. Confidential.
Oh, you can't pass up $1 billion. Believe me, my boy, it just isn't thrifty.
Yeah, I know, General. But I always been kind of sporty with money. Bye, y'all.
How do you like that? Well, I'm not giving up, not yet. There's $1 billion in that drug, and I'm not selling short. Not by Merrill Lynch, Pierce, Fenner, and Bean, I'm not. Bob, what's this Sadie Hawkins Day?
Oh, a monstrous dog patch custom, with the gals chasing the men, and married as soon as ever they catch him.
Get an outsider on her?
Show can.
Aha! Then we've got it! We go to dog patch. Appassionata enters the race. She runs the race. She catches Abner Yoakum. She marries Abner Yoakum. And by community property, she owns half of everything he does. Specifically, Yoakumberry Tonic. And then if some unfortunate accident should befall the poor fool, you, his young widow, will be sole possessor of the entire drug.
But Woolsey, supposing I don't catch him, I never run.
You'll run this time, it'll be back at Howard Johnson. Walkbound, can you make sure she catches him on Sadie Hawkins Day?
General, I know the man for the job.
Things of Passionata, we're heading for the hills. I tell you, by Tennessee Ernie and Tennessee Williams, we'll show those hillbillies what's what. Right?
Right.
Thank you.
thank you for saving our time from being bombed.
Ah, of course, hardly nothing.
Hey, Abner, how's our guillotine husband doing up there in Washington?
They're doing just fine. They turned into handsome, good-looking men like me.
Just for Washington, son. Is it run by a bunch of crooks?
No, sir, Pappy. The Washington's the right part of town. Everything's made out of big old white marble, and you can't hardly spit without it hitting the National Shrine. Right, Sam?
That's right, and I ought to know, because I let it chaw tobacco going in a strong wind. It ricocheted around the Washington Monument, flew past old Abe Lincoln, and come to rest on Jefferson's Dome.
Thank God! It didn't hit none of the
Confederacy! Thank God! Sam got a $5 fine. They got a law up there. It says you can't deface the National Shrine.
Never mind about no National Shrine, Sam. That's about Washington. Oh, damn crap.
There ain't no crooks up there, Pappy. As far as I can see, Washington has a nice mess of people. And I can tell you this one right now. The country's doing just fine. Right, Sam?
You is so right, boy.
Them city folks and we uns are pretty much alive.
Though they ain't used to living in the sticks.
We don't like stone or cement, but we is in agreement when we get down to talking politics. The country's in the very best of men. The best of men. The best of men.
The Treasury says the national debt is climbing to the sky.
Government expenditures and their bids align.
It makes a fella get a gleam of pride within his eye to see how our economy expands. The country's in the very best of hands.
The country's in the very best of hands.
The best of hands.
The best of hands.
You ought to hear the Senate when they're drawing up a bill. Such legal terminology would give your heart a thrill. It's racist, but you know one understands.
The country's in the very best of hands.
The building boom, they say, is getting bigger every day. And when I ask the feller how can everybody pay, they come up with an answer that makes everything okay. Supplies are getting greater than demands.
The country's in the very best of hands.
Senators are dumb. They run into problems that is tough to overcome. They just declare the thing they call a moratorium. The upper and the lower house suspends.
The country's in the very best of hands.
The sword is decked to nominee. The nominee's decked to treasury. When he ain't connected to treasury, he sits around his thigh bones. He sits around this place they got, this big congressional parking lot. He sits around out of you know what, a bed of my Bibles. Them folks gonna rise, get some exercise, print jobs here for tax, so to our eyes, yeah. When they're swapping their Bibles,
the country's in a very nice of man.
Another fellow recommends it should be 93. But 89.5%, who cares about the green? It's parity that no one understands.
The country's in the very best of hands.
GOPs and Democrats, she takes the other one. They's always criticized how the country should be run.
But neither toss a puppet, but the other's gone and done. As long as no one knows where no one stands.
The country's in the very best of hands.
It sits around this place red, where folks' cogs has always said. It sits around on her excess bed. Up there the golden flag goes. They sits around and it starts to snore. I had the floor. This is not my 74.
thing to find. So wise came one bunch, double your size again. Do my darnest to let you catch me, because if anybody deserves me, you do.
Available!
Well, howdy, Daisy, mate. What's on your scintillating and well-built little mind?
I was wondering if you could fix, arrange to make sure the Sadie Hawkins day comes out right.
So I can't better.
Naturally.
Daisy Mae's friend. You know what you're asking? That I betray my neighbor? That I sell out my fellow man? What is there in the whole world that could make you think that I could think of such slimy death, more deep activity, and human degradation?
50 cents?
Probably $1?
Maybe good.
All right. Adam, if he stopped in there rent today, my only diabolical device in creation, fully guaranteed to free the very trained bachelor in the whole life.
Namely?
To find Jones.
It's a deal.
Now run along, honey.
There's our man now. Available. Come on over here and meet the honorable.
Welcome to Dogpatch, General. I'd say what's on, what's the pleasure, but I see done right away with you.
No, we must stop Joker. Done this trash. The passion out of here can catch him.
There's only one man for the job. Refugee from justice, a man hiding out there in these hills, a man who's been comprised of three followers worth of the English in the language, namely, Li'l Abner.
You like legal? What's he like?
Fix your... Yeah, fix your, a man, 5 feet 4, a messy man, fix your, a hat covering your face, a sinister attachment. Picture,
2 eyes, staring out with super mad intent.
Come call me,
stay
over here and meet the general.
You're actually paralyzed with your eyes?
It's known as legal status, for activation, truth, whammy.
Can you put this whammy on after yoga so that this fun climax here can catch him this afternoon?
Absolutely. Kick pictures, guns go off, bachelor's running, baby pursuing. Young Yoko comes by,
I jump up and down, rotate my ball. Let's fly with a triple whammy. This hits young Yoko, smack in the back.
What happened?
Well, his bone marrow freezes, pain can affect rods, all the red ovals and white ovals. All of a sudden, his son stops standing stupid stare at you, though. Whereupon, the disappointment is that young lady smacks young Yoko.
Is he dead?
But Yoko cannot tell.
You guarantee he'll thaw out?
Absolutely.
Legal, you deliver Yoko, and you've got a job with me for life.
At your service.
Fire freak from that little fella. He's the same color as my name.
Thank you. Statewide in Washington, D.C. Here in our nation's capital, the secret government tests on the Abner Yoakum miracle drug continue behind a cloak of top echelon security. While little is known of the progress of the six guinea pig volunteers from Dogpatch, rumor has it that their reactions have exceeded fondest hopes of the jubilant government scientists working in their super secret laboratory.
Precisely alike. What delicious conformity. What fantastic implications when you consider that whoever controls this yokelberry colony may well control the world. Think of the unbounded horizon of science where we can make all mankind look, act, think, feel, hope, desire, dream, buy, sell, inhale, and exhale exactly like these specimens right here.
Happy day when miracles take place. And scientists control the human race. When we assume authority of human chromosomes and set in line with the mayor of Dogman, settle down and punish bloody clones. Oh, happy day when all the cells conform. And the exception all becomes the norm. When the gamma test and reproduce our nature.
Couldn't tell the name of the country.
My lips are sealed, but you can see the urgency. The president says that the test be completed by midnight tomorrow.
I see.
Good day, gentlemen.
Good day. Dr. Smithmore, you take the volunteers below for their mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermidite phonoscope.
To the rear, march.
Thank you, pardon, Dr. Smithfield, sir. Just what is a mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermidite
phonoscope? Dr. Smithmore, you mean to tell me that you, a super secret scientist in the government's super secret supersonic laboratory, don't know what a mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermidite phonoscope is?
No, sir.
Well, how did you get a government job?
I was terribly loyal.
Dr. Grobmeier,
yes.
Tell the dog patch and notify the wives and the volunteers that their husbands will be released tomorrow. If they want to come to Washington to pick them up, they may do so at government expense.
Very good. Oh, Dr. Finsdale. I don't want to seem stupid, sir, but precisely what is a mass spectrographic isotope double diathermal diaphonoscope?
How the hell do I know? I'm terrible love, too.
I know how you feel. I miss them, too.
It's a special offer today, Sam. I've got this terrible feeling that Li'l Abner's in real mortal danger.
What makes you so sure?
I always get this terrible feeling when he's in danger. It's like a clutching, grabbing feeling right here. You know what I mean?
Of course I do, honey. Every time I get that feeling, it's either I'm out of gas, the approach of a creditor, or I button the wrong button on the draw.
Oh, I'm so miserable, Sam.
If you think Li'l Abner's in real mortal trouble, why don't you go have Mammy conjure up a vision to see if he's all right?
I did, and she's in conjure up a vision right now. But I don't know if she can conjure all the way to Washington.
Oh, don't you worry about Mammy. She can conjure.
But I sure wish she'd hurry.
I can hardly wait till we get there.
I wonder what they look like.
Hi, Daisy.
Hi, Sam.
Hey, where you going?
We're going to Washington to pick up our new beautified cousins.
Yeah, the government sent for us.
What you got there?
We bought these from available dollars.
Special happiness guaranteed on your second honeymoon. You just love it.
Well, what's in there?
There's a black lace study, some sweet skeleton food. Fancy styles and music.
Dee Dee, do you see Li'l Abner when you're up there?
Well, look around.
Make sure to tell him I hope he's happy.
Sure, babe. We'll tell.
Come on, we gotta get down to the station. We'll buy a ticket.
Bye, Daisy.
Bye, Daisy.
Oh, Sam, they're all so happy I could almost cry.
Now, everything's gonna be just fine.
How can that be? Now that my man's gone, I'll just never get married.
What do you say that for?
I've waited around for so long, I'm 12 ways away.
That may be, honey, but what you got left over is more than what most folks starts out with.
No, Sam, there's no doubt about it. I looked in the mirror this morning, and my good years are gone.
Well, I guess you're right. After all, you is pushing 18.
I'm past my prime.
What a shame.
And I'm losing
yes,
time.
The old clock's run down.
17 last spring.
What a waste in life.
Still without a ring.
I'm
past my peak.
Losing early energy.
Look at this cozy.
Just hear the old bones creak.
Yeah.
your prime.
Get the trophy and drink.
Not overtime.
And make it take all day.
Every sun that sets.
All through the day and breath.
Brings you no regret.
And glad you sail away.
You climb the heights.
Eyes over the hills.
A romantic night.
My hand is lost in skill.
Comes in the full time.
Jaguar and drive him off the nearest cliff. Capital! Prioritize him at once.
Okay, I'm gonna get him loaded.
Loaded?
You know, gas, pickle, the influence of alcohol.
But, Wolsey, you know Abner doesn't drink.
Why not?
He says he's a 100% red-blooded American, and no 100% red-blooded American drinks, smokes, toasts, not jokes. That's because
then who gave this country a population of 250 million? There must be some way to get that boy to take a drink.
How about the sign card you're giving for us tonight?
Oh, we've got him! No 100% red-blooded American would dare to refuse to toast his prospective bride. Champagne, all right?
Champagne, point.
Good. Now remember, we each have a part to play. You too, Appassionata.
Supposing I lost everything up. What's that?
You'll be back pushing those 28 flavors before noon!
Stay a while. You are more
still have that little home.
No, we can't, Daisy.
Run away with me now.
I can't. Yes. I give my word.
Yes, you can.
Daisy, you're making us kind of a poor girl feel miserably in love with me.
No, I'm not, Abner.
So I can't blame you, because I can see I'm happy.
Yeah. Run for your life, Abner Yoakum. That's right. He's aiming to kill you. That General Bulmos and his precious intended.
How can you say such a terrible thing?
But it's true. I just heard it in this very room.
Daisy, I'm starting to get angry.
No, Abner.
Go home and forget all about me.
No, Abner.
You heard me. I have spoken.
Mammy, Pappy, did you hear?
We sure did.
We've got to get the rest of the king. We're going to save Li'l Abner's life, whether he wants it or not. Even if we got to bust into that ballroom tonight.
Right.
Social Security, old age pension, filtered cigarettes. I told them they wouldn't listen. I said, you put a radical like Herbert Hoover in the White House, and they call it progress.
Progress is the root of all evil. Progress is the cause of it all. Our living standards now so good. I had to change my neighborhood.
Say, we're in Levittown.
Millionaires are getting old-fashioned. Labor is the new
Well, all right. But you's mine now. Forever and forever.
Yes, Mr. Quig. I'm yours.
Little Abner's. But you can't do that. You can't just leave them like this. You just can't.
Come on in here, boys. Suppose I was to tell you that there was a way for you and your friends to get rid of your miserable condition.
Ah, Pappy, don't make light of the subject so serious.
But there is a way, son, there's sure a way.
Ah, Pappy, I've taken enough potions and tonics already.
But you haven't taken Corporal's poppy for perpetually passionizing and romanticizing love potion yet, now, have you?
Well, what does it do?
All I can tell you is that when I was your age, I had a mighty deal of trouble myself.
What?
Well, I took me a swig of that potion, and as I wiped my lips, your sweet, ugly little baby came a-walking by. All I can tell you is that sort of, dried up, shriveled up little thing looked to me like Kim Novak, Mary Miles Minter, and Lillian Russell rolled in the mud.
Well, what's the wait for? Come on, boys.
Wait a minute. There's one special condition that goes along with that potion.
What is it?
It only works if you really want it to work.
Oh, I does, Pappy. I sure does.
And number four, how about you boys?
We does too.
That's me. That way, that way. Man, no things. And with that way, that comes both. Come on.
Come on, fellas.
Western Union, I got to fix the telegram to Daisy Mae Scratch.
Mary, you're going to save. Message? Just one word. Stop.
Of course, my dear.
With their nice, new, rich
Relative?
Most assuredly, my pet. Rich relative? Who?
Why, you, of course.
Me?
You don't think a scrag will let another scrag go homeless long as they're related to anyone as well-heeled as the world's dirtiest wrestler?
You went there. Two miserable scrags come live with us?
Of course, the others will be along directly.
Others?
I sent Speedy McRabbit to tell them all the good news. I knew you'd want it that way, Earthy dear.
Well, I... How they?
Why, it's Uncle and Social Scragginess, three fine children. Unthinkable, unwashable, and unbearable. Say hello to your new rich uncle.
I'm looking for
all
the swamp,
look after
Tyson's
grave. Why, by that fellow, this is Tyson's grave.
Well, Sam, ain't you got some marrying to do?
I sure has. Back down your hatches and grandma holding each other while they're swallowing my $8 bill.
They couldn't do that, but they couldn't these things.
I'm almost done. The plane and the bomb are already on their way.
But I've only got one more word.
Not one more word. Not one more syllable.
Just a little word.
Out. On your way. Do you hear me? Out. Come on. Let's go. Statue.
Well, I don't even know without my statue. You know what, bitch?
Something's wrong with the statue.
You in the name of reason, please get out of here.
Something is on. Abraham Lincoln.
Trucks are... Abraham Lincoln.
Let's listen here. Because of his lack of strategy, his military blunders, and his general ineptness, which almost single-handedly encouraged the North to win this civil war, a grateful government dedicates this day to General Dowagiac, proclaiming it National Shrine.
Good God, it's a National Shrine.
That's right, and you can't face a National Shrine.
Huh?
You can't face it. You can't move it, and you can't bomb it.
You're absolutely right. It comes what you did to stop that plane. System dogpatch, evacuation is ended.
Why?
This wedding cannot be consummated until we pay homage to the one man who made all this possible. Who romanticized this boy? Who put them back the way they was? Saved our town from being bombed. None other than that beloved man is sitting up there on that beloved horse. Well, you relation keep hope on
thing. Traditionally, every year, seniors get Mr. and Mrs. Cooper a gift because of all their hard work. And this year, we made a wreath for them. And the master was drama.
He's offered a lot of guidance and help. He's been, you know, easy going, but he's firm when he needs to be. And it helps a lot, you know? Through the years, he's been really important to me, Brad. I'm sure everyone here, you know, when these guys get to be seniors, are going to feel the same way. Mr. Cooper has been a big impact on our life and has helped us all very much.
Yeah, we've learned more here than in almost all of our classes.
Orchestra.